That's a very crucial step there, is hitting that button. Thank you all so much for being here. Tonight we are going to be making these dream catchers, or my spin on them. So we have them from advanced all the way down to beginner, like I was saying a minute ago, and I'll repeat it now that we're on record. If you just absolutely feel like you cannot do the string work to these, you don't have the patience, you can use anything in the center of these. I used a paper doily here that I cut out of Prima paper in a Cherry Lynn Designs die, but you can use paper doilies, lace, fabric, anything you want. I mean, you could just take string and just wrap it all funky. Just Google it or look on Pinterest and you will see a million and one ideas that I promise will inspire you. So it's super easy to do. The base of the dream catchers, I'm fixing to show you. I get at Michael's and it's in the leather section. It's just called Dream Catcher Kit. That's what it's called. And they come in varying sizes. These are tiny. These are just metal rings. You can use embroidery hoops. You can use, I've done grapevine wreaths in the past. Anything you want to use, you can use. So, but yeah, it's just a really thick, like metal ring that's really sturdy. And it'll be in the leather crafting section at Michael's. They'll have, you know, all the traditional elements that you would use with these, but I always end up using my own. But yeah, it's over there in the leather crafting aisle. And my Michael's, it's in the adhesive section. So check there. Okay. Let me go ahead and make some announcements really quickly. The next show coming up is Tuesday at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, and Delina will be creating a mini album using a old hard-covered book along with the debutante collection. See the Prima blog for details. It was on there today, and it is absolutely gorgeous, and I just got my hands on the debutante collection today, and it is absolutely amazing. It is so, so, so amazing. I love it. Second announcement is Prima Art Ventures coming up. Edmonton, Canada, September 2015, and Anaheim, California, January 2016. Again, all the information is at primamarketinginc.com for the art ventures. So keep your eyes peeled for those. I so wish I could come to one of those. It's like my dream to come to a Prima Art Venture whenever I see the pictures. I'm always so jealous, though. If you are able to go, ladies, go. You will have a blast. Okay. So to start, like I said, I did a lot of prep work already. I went ahead and wrapped all of my rings with the string just to save time. So I'm going to go ahead. We're going to be making this one first. So I'm going to move the other two out of the way, and then we will get started on the first one. And I think I can kind of keep it in view that way you guys can see as I go along. But I'll give you a close-up really quickly. I use seam binding to wrap this one. I use the Relics and Artifacts. I love these wings oh so much. They're absolutely beautiful. And I love that the Relics and Artifacts combine some of the same elements into different packs. It just makes it amazing. You can get different options, but still, like, the wings are in a couple of different packs because I'm going to use these wings like crazy. So I've used the resin feathers that Prima carried. It was from a couple releases ago. And then I also used some flowers in like a non-traditional way. I just ripped them apart and used them kind of as feathers. And then paper feathers, of course, with the Prima paper, which I've shown how to make in the past, but I will go over that again. So this is the first one we'll be creating. I'm going to go ahead and move that out of the way. So I wrapped my metal ring with the seam binding. You're signed up, Barbara. Awesome. I'll try to pay attention to chat as much as I can. I want to go ahead and say thank you to everybody for coming. So if I miss you, I'm so, so sorry. Okay, so I wrapped this with the seam binding, but for the center part, I'm going to be using some of the Prima trim, and this is called the Bubblegum Wax Cord. It's got like a waxy finish on it, which is great because when you're doing dream catchers, you really want something that's going to not be slippery, if that makes sense. So this is perfect. The item number for this is 576776. Okay, so I'm going to pull off an ample amount. The good thing about these is you don't want to have too much string because it gets really messy, but you don't want to have too little either. But if you run out of string, you can always tie in extra string, and I may do that on purpose just to show y'all what I mean. So if you're making these at home and you're not done with your design and you run out of string, don't panic because it's a really easy fix to just tie another piece of string on there. So to make it easier on myself, I always take some waxed thread. And again, this is in that same leather craft section at your local Michael's or craft store. And it's like a really, it's almost like a bread twisty tie. It's really thick and you can twist it. So what I do is I take the excess cord that I have and just kind of wrap it up a little bit. I don't want too much of a mess, or otherwise I'm going to get all tangled up while I'm trying to make this, and that's a nightmare. So I'm just going to wrap some of this up, just going back and forth like that. And then I'm going to twist that waxed cord around it just to make my little tail a little bit shorter. And it'll just save me some hassle in the process. Okay, so I'm just going to take that, wrap it around it like a twist tie. Oh no, what stopped? Okay, I'm glad it's working now. I thought it was me. I'm like, uh-oh, can they see me? Okay, got a little tangle going on there. Of course, when I'm doing things live, everything that can go wrong does, so I hope this goes smoothly. Okay, so I just wrapped it up like that. It's just a little easier to keep up with detail that way. All right, so to start your dream catcher off, super easy. You're just gonna tie a little knot right up here. Easy peasy. Leave the excess string on there for now. I'm gonna do a double knot just to make sure it stays on there. And if you want to hang these with the string, you'll want to make a really big tail right here. So do a pretty big sized loop, if that makes, I mean a pretty big sized tail if that makes sense. And then you can make a loop to hang it with. But I don't do mine that way. Okay, so from here, you guys, all I have done is tie it. And I hope I can show y'all this and it makes sense and you feel like you can achieve it, okay? So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just measure how far apart you want it to be. Nothing has to be exact. I'm just gonna look and space it with my eyes. I'm gonna go to about right here. So all you're gonna do is take this, goodness, y'all, losing my words. Take the string, flip it over it, and you're just gonna go back under where you went over at. We've got a lot of string now, so it's gonna be kind of hard to show that, but when we get down to the tighter parts, you guys will understand a lot more. So you're just creating a little loop, but you wanna make sure you come through on the inside where you went across at. Hope that makes sense. So you're making just a little loop right here, and you're pulling it down, and you're not making an exact knot, you're just kind of making it to where it's kind of hooked on there and it's not going to move. So I hope that you guys can see that and it makes sense. As I go along, you're literally repeating the same thing over and over. So if you didn't understand at that time, I promise you will. And after I do the outside edge, it'll get a lot more obvious what I'm doing. So you're just going to keep going over and under and creating your dream catcher over and over, and just keep a tight pull on it because you don't want it to unravel. If you have loose hands, you can tie a knot every single time you do this, just so it's, you know, foolproof. If you accidentally let go, you're not gonna lose all your progress. Okay, so I'm gonna keep going around, and again, I'm using the bubblegum wax cord from Prima. This stuff is amazing. So I've got three spots so far, and you're just gonna go all the way around like this. Okay, so traditionally, you would just do the same spacing all the way around on your dream catcher, just kind of measuring with my eye. If you want to be exact and use a ruler, you're more than welcome to. Me, I just eyeball it. Sometimes if I'm doing smaller ones, I'll use my finger. But I'm just trying to kind of evenly space each one of those. But to make a cooler design, all you have to do is just start playing around. So I'm going to kind of do smaller ones now. I'm going to do smaller spaces, so one side of the dream catcher is going to be larger than the other one, and it creates a really, really, really cool effect. Okay, good, Robbie, I'm glad. If you guys haven't caught on to this, I promise as I go along, I'm literally repeating the same steps over and over, so I promise you'll understand it. And just practice makes perfect. There are a million tutorials on variations of these, so there's really no right or wrong way to do it. As long as you get that, get a little knot right there, you're good to go. So I'm just doing smaller little spacing right here than I was on that side. You can see I did much larger spacing over there. And you'll see at the end how that kind of creates a cool design. All right, so I'm almost back to the beginning. I'm just pulling it very tightly. I know that's kind of hard to convey on here, but I am pulling it very tightly. Okay, so I'm just going over my hoop and then back through it. And now that we're back to the beginning, it will make a little more sense, I hope, as to what I'm saying here. Okay, let me go over a little bit here. And you can always, if you make a mistake, just loosen it up with your other finger. No big deal. This is very forgiving. Okay, once you get back to the beginning and you've gone all the way around, you're just going to start on your next section. You just start hooking it right there. So that's going to be our next space. And we are just going to slip the cording through. And this is where it gets kind of tricky. The smaller the dream catcher, you're going to need a little bit of patience, okay? So you're just going to go through to the other side and just keep repeating the same steps over and over and over, just like that. So now we're going to the actual string instead of the metal wire, the metal ring. We're just going to the string and attaching from now on. Okay, so I'm going through my little section here. Just pull your string all the way through. So I'm just pulling it through like that and then just putting it back through on the left side of the string. And that creates a little knot. I hope everybody is clear on that. It's kind of hard to explain, but once you try it, you'll be like, oh, okay, I get it. No, it's not hard at all. All right, so I'm just gonna start going a little bit faster because this does take a little bit of time. The cool thing about dream catchers too is you can kind of, you can stop wherever you want. It doesn't have to go completely through to the center, which you'll see on another one. I used one of the Finnebar mechanical clocks in the center of it. Hello, Gabby. Hello, everybody. So hopefully y'all can see what I'm doing so far. If you have any questions, let me know, and I will be more than happy to help ya. Let me try to catch up from Argentina. Next week I will go to California from Argentina. Wow. Now I would like to go to Argentina. I so envy all you ladies that get to travel. I got my passport about 3 years ago and it has no stamps in it. I've never been anywhere. Haven't even made it to Cha yet, but one day. Just make sure after you go through the loop, you go to the left side. That's what creates your knot. And this, if you have like carpal tunnel or something, take your time with this. Don't feel like you have to get it done all at once. You can tie a knot at any point and come back to it. So don't feel like you have to finish it all in one go. You can, you know, take a break in between. Like I could tie a knot right here and just leave it. All right, so now we're back around again to the beginning. So I'm gonna start on the next little section. And you just wanna make sure you're getting it in the middle every time. I don't think I mentioned that. So every time you go through a section, make sure your knot is in the middle of it. Scrapping corner, I'm reading yours about your dream catcher. Yes, mine was very sloppy and loose the first time too. That's why now I pull it really tight, and it does tire out your hands, but you need it to be tight. If you guys don't have any waxed cord, I know you're gonna think I'm like crazy for saying this, but you can use dental floss. I have seen tutorials where they use dental floss, and I hear it works really, really well. Yes, I'm gonna put some beads on it. For sure. I'm going to go ahead and get a few layers around really quickly, and then I'll start doing the beads. And I'm going to be using the Memory Hardware glass beads. In fact, now that I'm at a good spot, I'm going to go ahead and start doing that. You were my reminder. All right, so I'm going to undo my little knot there. Let me cut off my little wax cording over here. I know you can't see what I'm doing, but it's kind of hard to show you with one hand. All right, there we go. So you can see now why I kind of grouped up my wire or my string. It would be a big long mess trying to pull it through every single time. So if it loosens up on you, no big deal, just tying it right back up again. So hopefully you guys can see. You're just going around and doing the exact same thing every single time. You can use it to make dream catchers. Yeah, if you don't like to floss, just pull it out and use it with dream catchers. It'll work, promise. All right, now I'm gonna just start using this without the little knot tied through there. It's short enough now. Okay, so to add beads, really easy, wherever you want to, it does not matter, it's completely up to you. just start adding beads. I'm going to be using the memory hardware ones, like I said, and the item number for that is, let's see here, 655350. They are so absolutely pretty. I love them so much. They're the glass beads, and they're amazing. Very pretty pearls. So to add the beads, just whenever you want to, get your string and just throw a bead on here. Now I did struggle because this is a really thick cord here, and the holes on these aren't as big. So just be careful with that. If you need to stick like a needle through the bead, go ahead and do that, just to make the hole a little bit bigger. But that's all you do, is just add it in there wherever you want to. You just string it on, and then it'll have some movement. You don't glue them or anything, you just let them do what they want to do. All right, so now that my string is smaller, hopefully I can show y'all one more time and you'll understand, just in case you forgot. You're just going through every loop and then pulling back through on the left side. That's it. And now I really am going to start going fast, because this, it is time consuming. Robbie, that's hilarious. Did you use your floss? Yeah, I used all of it. It's all gone. Do not, I mean, I've used embroidery floss, but it did not work as well as anything that's waxed is going to work a lot better. It has a really good grip to it. So when you're making these little knots like this, it does not move at all. It makes it a lot easier. Yes, I love, 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 love these glass beads, Carrie. I'm a pearl fanatic anyway, and these are just such good quality, and I love the colors. They're such a vintage colors. I love them. Okay, so hopefully you can see how the design is kind of starting to vary on one side, because I did larger hoops on one side and smaller on the other. So just play around. You could do like two large ones, one small, two large, one small. The more I've done dream catchers, I just played along, and you can come up with some really cool designs. And there's one lady I found on Pinterest. She does the most amazing work. She can do like spider webs with hers and all these intricate things that I would never be able to do, but it's pretty amazing. So I'm not going to add a ton of beads just for time, because we do have three of these to do, and I want to show you all three of them. But you can see on the original that I did use more beads than this, and then when we're done, I will show you something else you can add as well. So we're just going to have one little bead on there for now. It's going to be over there. So when you go to this hoop, this bead's in my way now, so just push it to the left or the right, depending on which side you want it on. I think I want mine to the right. And then just go through that loop. Do your knot in the middle, and your bead will stay right over there to the right. And he is nice and secure now. The closer you get to the middle of the dream catcher, the quicker it gets. The outside is always the longest part. And I love when I use the perfect amount of string, because I hate to waste. I think on this one I used just about the right amount. He used to get hair bands for my dogs from the kids' orthodontist. That's hilarious, Robbie. Resourcefulness, whatever you got to do. Hello, Peggy. I just see you on there chatting. Hello to everybody. If I've missed you, I'm so sorry. I'm trying to hold this thing tight and talk and then check the chat. That's like way multitasking. That's too hard for me to do. All right, we are almost to the center. In fact, I might cut it a little short just for time purposes. You don't have to go all the way to the center. Whenever you like the design, you can just tie a knot. So if you want like a hole there, you could definitely do that. I'm going to go a little bit further, but I wanted to show you all the pattern so far. The further in you go, the better your design looks, but if you're lazy like me, sometimes I cut it short. Hello, hello, Peggy. For the hoop, Barbara, I used it's like a solid metal ring. And at Michael's, it's called a dream catcher kit. It all comes like multi-pack, or little ones, big ones. You can get them all together, or just single-sized individually. And mine are in the leather crafting section at Michael's. on the adhesives aisle, aisle 61, if anybody wants to come to Panama City and get yours. All right. But you can use anything you have at your house that is round. I've seen some really amazing things where people took, stag horns and did a dream catcher in between them. One lady used just wood, and she would do dream catchers in between the branches, and it was the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. So you can just definitely get creative and do whatever you want. Dream catchers can be made with anything. Okay, I think this is a good stopping point. I like to stop. There's fireworks going off. If y'all hear that, I'm not sure what's going on, but there's fireworks. You want to stop when your circle looks even. You know, you don't want to stop where it looks all off-centered or, you know, like you didn't go around the correct amount of times. So whenever you're done, which I am, all you're going to do to finish it off is hold this little knot really tightly, and then you're just going to create a knot. I'm going to go back through that same loop. But this time, instead of going to the left, I'm going to go to the right, and I'm just going to tie a little knot. That's it. That's all it takes. And now it is secured, and it's not going anywhere. So I'm going to leave this dangling because I'm going to attach feathers and all kinds of really cool things on there. So you can see the design pattern, and everything's so backwards with this camera. It's so weird. I did smaller spaces over here, so it created like this really unique design. So that is it for the center part of your dream catcher, okay? That is it. And I know that probably looked harder than it really is. It's not hard. I swear, I promise, it's not hard at all. Okay, so you want to leave some dangling. You can kind of move it around and decide which piece you want to be, you know, your bottom, your side. I think I'm going to have this be my left side and the smaller spacing on my right, okay? So even though this was our starting point, I'm going to glue this down right here using hot glue again because I love it. I'm just going to make sure my tail is glued nice and securely on there, and then I'm just going to cut the excess off. So even though that was our starting point, it's going to be the bottom now. So I just had to cut that tail off. Okay, so now we are going to add our lace around it. Once you know which side you want the right to be, I added lace on this one on the right side, and this is just a generic lace I had in my stash. I wish I had Prima lace because it's like the most beautiful lace in the world, but I didn't have any. Let me make sure what side I want this to be on really quickly, y'all. I think this is going to be my bottom. Give me a minute while I play with it. That way I don't have too far to date. Actually, no. Okay. This is how we're doing it, and it's official. I'm so sorry, y'all. I'm so indecisive. Okay, because I want to be able to dangle things from this part right here. So that's going to be how mine is oriented. So I'm going to take some hot glue and just some generic lace from my stash. And I'm going to start at this point right here because I only want it to be on the right. And I'm just going to flip my dream catcher over. And since we have seam binding on there, this does give the lace something to adhere to. Obviously, if it was the metal ring, it wouldn't adhere very well with just hot glue. Just taking my finger and just going around it. So you can see what it's going to look like when you're all done. Just go section by section. If you want to apply lace all the way around it, you're more than welcome to. If you want to skip the lace altogether. The beauty of these is that you can really do so many different designs. It's just super fun. Especially with your Prima supplies, because they've got just the most perfect embellishments for this. Especially the resin feathers. I was so tickled to get those to use on this. Which I know if you guys have gotten some of the newer collections, the new chipboards that come with it, the coordinating chipboards, have those feathers in them. And we're going to be doing some cool things using those too. Because they are really cool. And I've been struggling to use them. I love feathers, but for some reason I have a really hard time incorporating them. All right, I'm just continuing to glue this all the way around until I run out of lace. And I did get the new craft mat. Hopefully that's a better backdrop for y'all to see what I'm doing on, as opposed to the last one I had. I might ruin it, but it's nice now. Okay, I've got that adhered on there. Yes, I covered the hoop with seam binding. It was just, what's the brand? I bought a huge lot on eBay, and I just covered it with seam binding. It's really hard to tell. But on this one, I covered with seam binding. On the other ones, I used this same bubblegum wax cording from Prima to cover the entire outside ring. But on this larger one, I used seam binding because it would have taken forever to cover it with this. That is the only reason why I didn't use the Prima one. Okay, now that we have that on there, we are going to start adding our embellishments. Time for my favorite flower of all time. This is the Summer Carnation from Prima, and it is by far my favorite vine ever made. The product number for this is 549077. I love this vine so much, you guys. It makes me very happy. Okay, so I'm gonna take the big flower off, and I'm gonna save it for later use. Just kind of wrap that wire around. So I'm just gonna start kind of curving this. It's all wired. It's very moldable. You can get it to fit on anything. So I'm just gonna start kind of molding it around to fit the left side of my dream catcher. Okay. Once I figure out how I want it, I'm gonna wrap some of these extra tendrils around just to keep it secure. So starting on the bottom here, I'm just going to insert the base of it around one time. Okay, so that part is connected. It's got wires in there, so it's going to stay really secure. All right, then I'm going to go up here. I'm going to use the top part to wrap around this one. Okay, just like that. Just wrapping it around. And then you can play with all your excess tendrils. You can curl them with a paintbrush, which I did with some of mine. Anything you want to do. You can take some of them, make them really tight little circles. Looks really pretty like that. Whatever you want to do. Okay. These are just the most amazing sprays ever. I cannot get enough of them. Yes, this craft mat has teal and black. The teal side is so pretty that I've refused to damage it. So I'll be using the black because I don't know. I just don't want to ruin the pretty teal side. Teal is quickly becoming one of my favorite colors. Okay, so we have our spray on there. You can kind of move the leaves around to get it how you want. No right or wrong way with these. Just move it around until you're satisfied. And now I'll show you guys on camera. My next show, hopefully I'll have this to where I don't have to keep turning things around and the camera is overhead. Since I lost that one, I'm going to go ahead and curl it. Okay, so that is what we have so far. I mean, you could be done here. You could add a couple feathers and bam, you're done. You've got a dream catcher. But me, I always add tons of details. So the first thing I'm going to add are some Relics and Artifacts wings. And I'm going to be using this package right here. Absolutely beautiful. This one's called Chivalry. And the item number is 941697. Now I did a finish on these that is different. I was kind of playing around with them. And I don't know if you can tell on camera. Hopefully you can tell. There's a couple different color variations. If you look on the Prima blog, you can kind of see. And I went ahead and prepped my wings just because it was a process. But I'm going to quickly run you through what I did, okay? Just to get some color variation, I went and colored it with some vintage decor paint. This is Martha Stewart. Use any paints you have on hand. This is just a really pretty like eggshell kind of color. So I primed it with that first, and then I went over it with some of the Prima chalk paint. And I think it was an egg blue. And now that I'm remembering that, I think I left that off the product list, Carrie. I'm so sorry. I will look back on there and link that back, y'all. I'm sorry. So after I did that, I just went back over it with dry gesso with my finger, and that was it. That is all I did to make these really pop. And for the last step, we're just going to use some of our watercolor pencils, which I'm absolutely in love with. I'm going to be using the Scenic Root. These are so versatile. And I did take my little styrofoam out because that did keep it from moving around, but for me, for some reason, I couldn't get them out when I did that. So I removed that. So let me find my water bottle really quickly, y'all. I lose everything during the show because I make such a mess. Okay. Got my water. Now I'm going to take the number 84. It's like a gold color. It's really pretty. You can see on the tip there. And all I'm doing is getting a little bit, just coloring in there like that, being very sloppy. That's what I love about these. Then you can just take your finger and smooth it out. So this is just giving you a lot of different color variation. It makes these look really, really detailed. These are so amazing. I absolutely love them. Every relic and artifact, it's so hard to choose which is my favorite, but the wings are probably up there. But when you go over it with this colored pencil, it just hits all those raised areas. I'm sure my camera's not doing it any justice, but it hits all those raised areas and brings out all the detail. And you can see I'm literally just like scribbling it on there and rubbing it with my finger. It's almost acting like a rub and buff. So I did one layer of eggshell paint, went on top of it with chalkboard paint, and then dry rub gesso. And then all I'm doing is this, and these bad boys will be done. And I wanted blue on this one, just for some difference. I know a lot of times we kind of cheat online with Freeman. We're supposed to be recreating the exact same thing, but sometimes you just want to change the color. Okay, so that is ready to go. I will be using that particular colored pencil again in a minute though. Okay. So to adhere these wings, again, I'm going to be using hot glue because it's my favorite thing in the world. These have a nice, flat, curved area, which are perfect for adhering to round items. I absolutely love that they did this because it's really hard when things are flat edged to get them on round objects. So these are perfect. So for this one over here, make sure I got this perfect. Okay, I'm just going to add a good little heap of hot glue. Just like that, not being perfect at all because this is going to be covered up for the most part, where the glue is anyway. The wing will obviously show, but you will not see any of that hot glue. All right, so I'm just holding it really tightly with my finger. I didn't see what y'all said about the leaves. I'm so bad about leaves. I do like leaves on sprays, but for some reason on flowers, I always pull them off. I don't know why, but on sprays, of course, you have to have them. All right, once that one is adhered and the hot glue is dry enough, and of course, since we're live, it's not going to dry. Well, you know what you can do, too? I'm going to totally cheat. I'm going to add like a big glob of hot glue right there. It looks terrible, right? But once I take this little flower and push it on there, that's going to really make sure my wing doesn't go anywhere. I'm a very impatient person and I cannot stand to wait on things to dry. So just doing that right there made the wings stay. So totally take advantage of your sprays and use them to adhere objects too. All right, I'm gonna do the same thing on this side, except let me make sure I got it lined up correctly with the other one. Okay, on this one, we're just gonna do the bottom half with hot glue and leave the top blank because it's gonna kind of get tucked behind there and you're not gonna see it. All right, we're just gonna hold this one tight for a minute until it dries. What did I go to the cop for pulling the leaves off? I know, Carrie, you love them. I saw on one new streamer you said that, or Frank maybe said he sends you all of his leaves. Maybe I'll start doing that, and then maybe I can come out of the corner. And when I see you use them, Carrie, I'm like, it makes perfect sense. They look so perfect on all of your projects. You know, with all of you ladies, but I, for some reason, I just think it looks terrible on mine. I don't know why, but I just cannot make them work. Okay, so I'm going to lay that flat until those dry. Now we're going to have some fun with the feathers, y'all. And we're going to use some petals here. Let me grab the pack of flowers that this came from. These are the flowers we're using as kind of like makeshift feathers, which they really look like petals, but in my head they look like feathers. This number is 567187, and these are the Tierra Aquas. So all I'm doing is pulling these apart. Please do not scream at me, ladies. I know, how can I pull these flowers apart, but I am, okay? I'm just taking them and I'm ripping them off of there. And that is where I got my little petals from. So don't be mad at me, but I did. I'm ripping all of these apart. Just to make y'all happier though, I usually do pull them off of only one side. So that way I can use this flower on another project. You know, you'll only see one side of it. You can kind of use it to layer. Now on this one, what I did to get this kind of two-toned effect is I took that same watercolor pencil, number 84, the gold one from Scenic Root, and I just went over the raised areas with it. Just dipped it in the water and just hit those raised areas on these petals and just gave it a really two-toned effect. Okay? All right, so I'm gonna start gluing those on there with some of this string. I'm gonna cut this huge string off. So what I do to get all of these feathers and everything adhered is I start taking pieces of the wax cording and just going in here to the center section and tying knots. Keep one of the little tails bigger than the other one just for some variation on the length. So let me grab some more. I love, love, love this wax cord, you guys. It's amazing. Okay, so I've got 1, 2, 3 tails. I definitely need a couple more, so I'm going to go ahead and tie one more knot. Okay, so we've got a nice variation of tails here. We've got 6 of them in total. 5 of them in total. I can't count, apparently. So we've got them just like this, okay? So all I'm going to do for some of these is I'm just going to add a little bit of hot glue on the back and adhere them directly onto here. Do, you know, be mindful of how much hot glue you're adding. Try not to make it look bad on the back because these are going to turn around, you know, unless you have them on your wall how you want them to be. They're going to kind of they're going to move around. So just make sure it looks nice and neat while you're doing this. Try not to be really sloppy with it. All right, so I'm just going to keep adding my little petals here that, yes, I tore off of a beautiful Prima flower. I'm going to be punished. I love these colored pencils, y'all. You can just scribble with them. You can use the watercolor brushes that Prima has. That's probably my favorite way to do it. But you can literally just scribble right on top of things. So I love the fact that you can do that. Ooh, that's a really good tip, Faith, Hope, Love, Art. I didn't know that, and I've been doing that. I've just been sticking my pencil down in water. So that's a good tip for me. Thank you. I appreciate that. Because now that you mention it, this gold one, that's what I've been doing with it, and I have been using it a lot more than the other ones. So that's a good idea. I'm going to be mindful of that in the future. Good idea. Okay, so now we're going to start adding some of our feathers. So when you get these chipboard kits, and for example, this one is from Timeless Memories. The number is 580193, and the top part you have all of these feathers, which are amazing, right? But I wanted to use them, but they're too big. And I was like, well, I can't use these, you know, and I just pushed them to the side. But since Frank sends his to Carrie, Miranda can send hers to me. I will, Robbie, I promise. So to be able to use these on something smaller, all you're going to do is just start ripping the bottom half of this off. I'm just ripping half of the feather off on both sides. So you can, if you have these and you've been wanting to use them, but you're like, they're too big, you can alter them, okay? So just pull as much off as you want to get them to the size that you need. You can even take your scissors if one is like too fat and literally trim around the outside of it, like I'm doing, just to make it smaller. So you can alter these feathers to make them work with any project. And I usually just kind of pull them apart to get a more natural look to it. And then I cut the excess stem off. And now we've got like the perfect sized feather as opposed to this really large one, okay? So that's all I did to those. Now, to get some really cool things going on with it, I just started using my Stampers Big Brush Pen in white and some different Prima stamps. Let me find them from my big old pile of a mess over here. 1 second, y'all. If I can't find them right now, we're gonna skip it. Okay, here we go. This is from the Bella Rouge collection. These are some of these stamps, and the number is 655-350. I absolutely love these, especially this little music notes. the little music note at the bottom. So pretty, right? I love it. Okay, so all I'm using is this white big brush pen. Use the chalk edgers, use anything you want, but since I'm going on black, I wanted to use white so it would show up really well. So I'm just going across my whole stamp with this and then just stamping it on there. And so much for that perfect matte. It's already ruined. See, Miranda, I'm terrible. Terrible with myself. I can't keep anything clean. Delana, don't watch this. She's gonna die. You know what? I'll put a little wrapper down. That way Delana doesn't have it fit. She likes a nice clean mat, I hear, so I don't want to get her upset today. Alright, so I'm just going all the way down with my stamp. So then you can see there's a really cool music note impression on there. And it just looks really cool. I mean, it just adds like added detail to that feather that wasn't there before. Not very, you know, it's not a gigantic change. It's subtle, but it gives me a little more oomph than I need. Okay. So on top of that, some really cool ways to alter your feathers are to use your Finnebear art ingredients. I'm going to be using the micro beads in silver for this particular one, and that number is 962562. And I'm going to be using the 3D matte gel from the Art Basics line, the 3D matte gel. It's like a staple, and this number is 961398. So all I'm doing is opening it up. Let me grab a little spare tray to dump this over. And I'm just going to dip the top of my feather in there. Just like that. Really messy, right? And just take my finger and just kind of, you want both sides covered too. So don't put a ton on there, but just, you know, coat where you want the beads to go. Okay. Cover this back up. And then just go over a tray, an embossing tray or anything you have, and just pour the beads on the front and on the back. And just kind of hit it in there to get the excess off. So that's what it's going to look like. When it dries, it becomes a lot cooler looking. It kind of hardens and you can kind of pull it back apart and get that natural shape back. But for now, we're going to set that aside to dry. So for some of my feathers, I use the micro beads. For some of them, I use the glass glitter, which I went ahead and already did that one to show y'all. Let me grab it really quickly. That is what the glass glitter looks like on there, and it is so pretty, y'all. It just, oh, it's absolutely beautiful. The glass glitter I used is the Gold Rush, and that number is 961657. So I did the exact same step, but I used this instead. And it is just so cool. It's really, really cool. Okay, so now that we have that, we are going to adhere our feathers to our string. So in order to do that, I'm just going to take a little bit of hot glue again because it's my best friend. I'm gonna put it right here at the base of the feather. And I'm gonna start wrapping my string around it. And I use glue because I like everything to stay still. I don't want to have to tie it and worry about it moving around. So I'm just hot gluing it on there for now. And then I'm going to cut the excess tail off. And then I'm just going to keep wrapping it. And you want to make sure both sides look good because, like I said, this is going to spin around a bit. So just keep wrapping all the way up your stem with the wax cord. And just add a little bit of glue here and there to make sure that it stays. Alright, so that one is done. I think on this one I'm just going to do one of the large feathers like that, and I'll use the other ones on the next feather, on the next dream catchers. Okay, so hopefully you can see so far what we have going on down here. Now we are going to add our resin feathers. These are so beautiful. They come in this huge wood tray, which can be altered as well. So I'm going to grab one of the small ones and then one of these curved ones right here. So the small one looks like that. Are absolutely beautiful. The item number for these is 573355. I love these so much. They are just so pretty. I also dipped these in the glitter on some of them, but for time I'm going to skip that tonight. But you can totally do the same technique with these and dip it in the glitter or dip it in the micro beads, whatever you want to do. So I'm going to add some more hot glue not a whole lot because I don't want a big mess, but just enough to get it to adhere on there. And I'm going to do a couple of wraps with the string too, just to make these really look like they're part of the dream catcher and not just glued on there. It is a muck. It is a mess, but it's really fun, you guys. I love getting messy with my ingredients like that. It's really fun. Okay, so I'm just adhering the feathers like that. Easy peasy, okay? Now, for the side here, our last step is to add some fussy cut elements. I used some of the Butterfly Collection, a little bit of Fairy Pixie Glen Collection in there as well. So I just fussy cut some flowers out. And I inked them with the Hydrangea Chalk Edger from Ingold Balm. And the item number's not on here, but it is linked on the blog. And I just glued them in different areas just to add some more detail. And again, I'm using hot glue because it is my favorite. And I'm just finding spots where I feel like it looks really empty. And I'm just adhering those additional flowers in there. Hopefully you guys can see that. I'm gonna go on both sides and just adhere it in there wherever I feel like it needs it. Are they being sassy tonight, Carrie? I wish after the show was done, you could go back and view the chat, and I could be completely like ignorant to the fact that you can do that, because I'd love to see what you guys talk about. I swear, whenever I look up, it is always so funny to see what you ladies are talking about. One day I'm going to do a really easy project so I can keep up with the chat while I'm doing it. I promise, one day. All right, so I'm just adding a few in here. I don't have to add too many. Okay, and that is it, you guys. You can keep adding more in here on your spray, but it's totally up to you how much you do. I also added some of my paper feathers, which I have shown y'all how to make these in the past. Let me find my stemple. All you do is cut a shape out of your paper. Let me grab my sample piece really quickly. All of my paper is hiding. There we go. Okay. So you just cut a little shape out of the paper. Just like that. Does not have to be perfect. And then you're just going to go on both sides and cut little tiny fringe on both sides of this all the way down. Okay. So it starts to create this really cool feather. I don't want to go in detail because I've shown how to do it before on a previous view stream, so I don't want to be repetitive. The only thing I did different was I took some of the, what is this called here? This is from Prima, and it is more of the trim right here. This is a wire trim though, so it's amazing. The number is 576981. Add that to the back of your feather and you can bend it and manipulate it into like really more natural looking positions, I guess, instead of just a flat one. So I'm going to adhere that one in here. Just a little bit of hot glue again. So you can go as crazy with this as you want or as minimalistic as you want. You can add tons of fussy cutting or not a lot. It's completely up to you. The last thing I did was add some of these beautiful flowers into my spray. These are the Isabella Dannies. The item number is 655350. And I'm just going to add one, two in there. And for Carrie's sake, I am not going to pull the leaves off. Look at that. I'm leaving it on there, Carrie, just for you. Because I want out of the corner. I don't want to be punished. So I'm going to add one down here at the bottom. And another one towards the top up here, just like that. It's kind of covering the other one, but it's okay with me. So you can see here what we have going on. So this one I did not add as much detail as I did to my first one. The first one I added more fussy cut details and a few more things. You can add sequins to the center here, and those chipboard packs that you get where the feathers came from, you have sequins as well. So I did add some sequins in there in different areas. So if you don't want to use beads, you can use sequins, you can use anything you want in there to create a lot more detail. All right, so for the next one, I think we're only gonna have time to do one more. and knew that that would probably happen. So since the other one is pretty much the same as far as the inside, I'm going to skip it and I'm going to do the easy one for y'all. The only thing I did different on this one was when I got to the, and I have, let me grab my piece that I prepped really quickly to show y'all. So this one isn't decorated yet, but I went ahead and went all the way around with my webbing. And all that I did for a little extra detail, this is a scrap piece of paper from the Coffee Break collection. I literally just traced my shape onto a few pieces of scrap paper. And then I just cut that shape out and adhered it into the hole. If we have time to go back to this one, we will, but it's literally the same design as the other one, minus that, so I don't really want to take up too much time. We'll come back to this one last, because I want to show everybody who feels like they can't do the webbing, I want to show you an easier alternative, okay? So we're going to skip that one for now. This one is our steampunk one, and it is so fun and so easy to make. All you need is lace, a doily, anything like that, and you can make a dream catcher. You don't have to do the webbing in the center. Okay, so for me, I used a die, and I die cut some Pixie Glen paper, really pretty paper. So I'm going to grab my hoop here, and all you're going to do the whole way around is take little pieces of string and tie it on the other side, just tying it in there. So don't feel like you can't make the intricate design ones, because you can always just make these. Let me figure out where my string starts. The wax cording, the pink, I'm not using it to tie through because I didn't want pink on pink. I was trying to use strings that had contrast and color. So that's why I'm going to be using this one this time. All right, so just cut little pieces off. And on this particular die, there are sections that kind of just, it's almost like a little clock. They're just sectioned off perfectly. So those are the little portions I'm going to be using to tie onto. So you're just going to stick your string through there. And let me, another tip is you can add a little bit of hot glue to the tip of your string. Let it dry a little bit. Yes, I have three made, but just in case we run out of time, I'm going to go ahead and show this one. I mean, it's just my tradition to run over, but I don't want to run over too much. Instead of making one, you know, I had to make three because that's just how I roll. Okay, so you're just going to go all the way around, and I just go ahead and adhere my strings all at one time. And just go through your holes of your doily. You can use lace if you have any fabric, whatever you want to use, you can use. Like I said, if you go on Pinterest, you'll find so many ideas. You'll be so inspired to do these, you guys, I promise. Just making sure I have a good hole to push this through. Okay, so I'm just adding the string through all of my little holes here. And then we'll tie them on at one time. And some of them don't want to go through, so you'll have to add a little bit of hot glue sometimes. My hands are immune to the burn of it, so it never bothers me. Of course it's going to give me grief because I'm live. So you know what, we're going to skip that hole and go to the next one. I'm going to cheat. Don't tell anybody. Okay. I mean, this has got to be easy on us, right? This one's supposed to be easy, so don't struggle. All right, we need one more, I think. And the only thing to keep in mind when you're doing this style is to tie these the same distance. So I'll show you what I mean. You just want it to all be even. So I'll start with this piece. You can see what it looks like. Just a big old hot mess right now. But just take it, hold it where you're kind of seeing your spacing, where you'll know your knot needs to go in a certain spot. So I'm just trying to see where my center is, like that. And now I know how tight to tie mine. And just do one knot the first time. When they're all tied, we'll go in and do a second one. We'll double knot it, is what I'm trying to say. Okay, so just make sure that you have a good space. I'm lying, I'm actually gonna go in and double knot it now for the first one. Okay, now all my other ones should be the same distance apart. So you just go through and just keep tying this off, making sure to keep it nice and even and in the center. I hear you guys are discussing the comment that was made, and I will just say for the record, I would never make anything with intention of disrespecting anyone's religion or beliefs or anything like that. I just want to make pretty stuff, and I promise you it doesn't go any further than that. I would never put another thought into creating. So I'm very sorry if anybody took offense. Definitely would never intentionally do that. All right, so I'm just tying this all the way around in double knots. And we'll cut our little tails off later. But for now, just making sure this is nice and centered. And it's not. I can tell it's off just a little bit, but it's okay. It's easily fixed. Once the show's over, I can easily fix it. All right, we've got one more to tie, and then we can cut our little tails off. Actually, you know what? I kind of like the look of just four. I'm just gonna do four. I like the symmetry of just having four pieces tied on there, okay? So I'm just gonna do four. All right, I'm gonna pull the tails around to the back, cut them off, and then I'm gonna add a little dab of hot glue and just push the excess down on there. I just like everything to be really secure. So that's all I'm doing. It'll look a little messy from the back, but you're not gonna see the back at all. Should be hanging up and you won't be able to see any of that. So I'm just adding glue back here just to make sure my tails don't come untied. And I'm definitely, like I said, immune to the hot glue. So don't feel like I'm burning myself. I'm not. It doesn't bother me. Oh, I should have told y'all, for this doily, I cut it out with the paper and I cut it out two times and adhered it to each other. That made it a little more thicker, so I wasn't worried about the paper ripping while I was making my dream catcher, okay? I'm not keeping up with the chat, y'all, so I'm very sorry if something has been said that I didn't address, but I am sorry, like I said, if I offended anyone. Never, ever, ever my intention. Never claimed these were, you know, authentic, traditional Native American dream catchers, nor would I, because those people have art form that is amazing. These are just my little take on them, and I like making them. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and add some clear gesso to my doily, because we're going to be using alcohol inks, which you guys are probably so sick of seeing me use, because I use them on every show, right? But I love them. All right, so I'm going to go around the outside, too, because we're going to add it to the outside on our bubblegum cording, because this one's going to be all grungy and steampunky. Okay, for the center part, I'm going to use a couple of different things here. I'm using these mechanical clocks from Thinabear. 961084 is the product number. I'm going to be using the smaller one. Go ahead and get that out there. Okay, going to be using, let me grab a few things. Bottle caps from the mechanicals as well, and the item number for those is 961091. It comes in a multi-pack. I used these right here. It's like the second largest size. They're so cute. I absolutely love them. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and grab my last mechanical if I can find it here, and we will start adhering. Everything hides from me when it becomes showtime, I swear. I'm going to take a picture of the aftermath of my desk area right now, because it's really bad. Before I cut this, the item number is 960285, and these are the clock faces, which are a staple for me. I think I have about 10 packs of them. But I use, like, I don't hoard things. I use things. I don't ever buy something just to hoard. I use it all. Okay, so I'm going to adhere that using some Beacon 527 multi-use glue. I'm quickly becoming a fan of this stuff. So I'm going to randomly apply some on the metal, and then you guessed it, I'm going to use hot glue in other places just to make sure it stays down. So I'm going to add a glob of hot glue there and a glob there. And then then you're just going to center this on your doily and then push down really quickly so your hot glue can dry. Okay, now we're going to take the heart from our Chivalry Relics and Artifacts. And like I said, this item number was 941-697. These are so fun to alter, y'all. I am so in love with them that I can't stop. They're amazing. It took me a minute to start using them, but now that I have, I just can't get enough of them. All right, so we're gonna get messy again with the micro beads, but hey, it's all in fun. I'm gonna be using the 3D matte gel again from Funabear, 961398. So we're gonna take the heart, and I keep this little eye pin in here just to hold it with. I'll be removing it at the end, but for this step, that's what I use to hold the thing. So I'm just putting a generous coat of this matte gel, 3D matte gel, but I'm trying to be even. I don't want like big clumps. I want it to be nice and smooth on my heart, And you might not be able to get the top area completely yet, but it's okay. Just make sure you get the bottom really good. All right, now we're gonna use those same silver micro beads. And we're just going to pour it on here. These hearts are so fun to alter. If you follow Sandra Evertson's Facebook, she will share the stuff that people create using her Relics and Artifacts. And I am telling you, some ladies are so creative with what they've come up with. All right, I'm just shaking the excess off. And now that I have it from this angle, I'm going to go ahead and get the top of it. Spilled a little bit of micro beads, no big deal. All right, then you're just gonna set that there to dry. That easy. I only did one coat. It was not perfect. There might have been a few gaps, but no big deal, right? Nothing has to be perfect with me. All right, so while that dries, I'm gonna go ahead and get my other elements ready. On top of my heart, I added this little element in. So I'm gonna use the same 3D gel in there. And I am getting it off the outside. I don't want a big mess, just a little mess, not a big one. I'm gonna use that same gold brush glass glitter. These things are just amazing. I love, love, love using all of these art ingredients. They're super fun. So I'm just adding that to the inside of it. I'm pouring the excess back. And I just use this little container right here to pour over top of just to keep it nice and clean. I agree with that statement, Peggy. You can't make everybody happy, ever. I wish I could. I'd love to never offend anyone and, you know, keep everybody happy, but it's not gonna happen. Okay, so for some of these top areas where the string is, I'm going to use some lovely Junkyard Findings from Ingold Balm. Let me find that container so I can give you the item number here. It is 891640. I'm going to be using these pieces right here. I'm not sure exactly what they're called, so I'm not going to attempt, but I just love all of these elements. They are so amazing. So I'm just going to adhere them right where the string is. And at first I had tried to use that to adhere my string, but it just got really wobbly and it wasn't sturdy enough. So I just glued it on afterwards. So I'm putting it at the edge of where my strings are. Lisa, I remember that. I don't even know why somebody would take the time to say something hateful like that. We all have different scrapbooking styles, so I would never, ever say something hateful like that to someone else. Okay, so we've got that on there. I'm going to grab my glass mat really quickly because I really don't want to ruin my beautiful new mat. And I'm going to grab my alcohol ink, if I can find it. Okay, and my water bottle. And now I'm just going to do the same thing I do all the time. You guys are probably so used to it by now. I'm just gonna spritz and then sprinkle on some alcohol ink. And we're 4 minutes over. I'd say we got about 10 more minutes. I'm not gonna do the other one just because it's just repetitive. You're doing the same thing that we did on the first one. On that one, I did tie like some lace on the bottom, but that was pretty much it. Everything else was the same. So I'm just adding alcohol ink, y'all, randomly. No rhyme or reason. Got the excess tap down. Just trying to make it nice and grungy looking. Let me grab a baby wipe. It's like a cracker staple. Dabbing up the excess. Just wanted this to be a grungy one. I usually always do soft, pretty ones. So just kind of wanted one to be a little bit different. Okay. So we've got our alcohol ink on there, nice and grungy. Scrapping corner, that's what my like regular saying, huh? We've only got this much more time and then we go way over. All right, so our beautiful little heart covered in the silver beads. And you can see it's not perfect. I've got a few pieces missing here and there, and that is completely fine with me. It's still wet right now, so I'm not going to remove that eyelet, but when it's done, I'll remove it. Okay, so this is going to be our top. I am going to adhere it on here. Let me grab my foam adhesive. Love, love, love this stuff. I'm going to use the bigger ones and just stick them down here. This is dry enough, so it's going to adhere. I'm just going to use three of them straight down the middle. Well, I lied. Maybe it's not dry enough. But it is. Why is it not working? There we go. Oh, goodness. Technical issues. I thought it was dry enough, but I guess it's not. So you know what? We're going to add a little bit of hot glue. Boom. Now it's dry enough. Totally cheating here. It's sticking to my finger. Okay. Here's how we're going to solve that. Boom. Just push it down the best you can. The best thing to do is to wait for this to be completely dry, and then you don't have to worry about all that, but I don't have time to, so. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and lift up the end and add some hot glue under there, just to make sure it stays still. Pushing it tightly. You definitely wanna make sure you double up on your paper doily. If you have a fabric one, I think that would probably work, but this is gonna take, you know, a lot of water, a lot of media, so you want to make sure it's nice and sturdy, and I don't think one thin piece of paper would have worked. Okay, so we've got our heart in the middle there. Now we're going to add our pretty little clock on top of there. And on the other one I did, I used another it's like the Marseille pool from Memory Hardware from Frank Garcia. I'll show you what I'm talking about one second. And it came out the center of it. This little door pool right here. I forget the name. But it's absolutely beautiful, and the product is linked on the blog. But I'm not going to use it on this one because I really like the look of the glass glitter in there. I think that looks really, really pretty. So we're going to totally skip that for now. Okay. Having some technical issues because I did not dry this. I was getting in a hurry, and that's what happens. So let me adhere that back really quickly. All right, so I'm gonna use some of these gorgeous flowers right here. These are the Giselle flowers. I used a blue one on the other one, but I don't have any more blue, so we're gonna go with this light lavender one. Very pretty. These are some of my favorite flowers ever from Prima. They're just absolutely gorgeous. I'm so in love with these. Just the shape of them is beautiful. So I'm going to squirt the center of it with water. Drop a few drops of alcohol ink just so it blends in with our dream catcher. The glass glitter is amazing. I really, really, really love it. Sorry, I was reading everybody's comments. I got spaced out for a second. All right, I'm out of hot glue, so let me grab some really quickly. And then we're gonna adhere our flower, our feathers, and we will be done. Close to on time, as close as it gets for me anyway. All right, so I'm just adhering this to the side over here. Everything is still really wet. I definitely should have dried this, y'all, so please forgive me, but time did not allow it. Okay. So So that is what it looks like so far. Now we're gonna add our flowers and feathers to the bottom. Oh wait, we got one more messy section to do. Where is my little bottle cap here? I love these so much. We're gonna do the same thing to the center of this one. I'm just adding some of that 3D matte gel and some more messy glass glitter. I'm gonna really like put a ton on there this time though. Yeah, the feathers are really fun, y'all. I played around with just using different stamps and I even hand drew some designs on some of them. I'll show you in just a second. But it was really fun to just play around with it and see what all you could come up with them. And now I know I can use them. At first, the size of them was like, oh, I can't use these, they're too big, but you can definitely trim them down. All right, so just adding the glass glitter in there. Dump my excess. Okay, now time to adhere everything to the bottom. I've got my feathers prepped already for this one. This was the one we did earlier with the stamping on it. Let me grab my other ones. I've got another brown one that just has the glass beads on it. And I'm going to go ahead and grab that wire thread that I showed you from Prima. This is trim. I think the color is called Ecru, and I could be mispronouncing that, but it's E-C-R-U. And the item number is 576981. Use your Timmy scissors or some good ones for this because this stuff is wired. So I'm just going to start cutting pieces of it. And what I did is I just pulled a little bitty tail up and then just twisted it like it was a bread tie. Hopefully that makes sense. Until it ended. I love those little emoticons. They're so cute. Okay, so that's what it's going to look like on the bottom. And then I'm just going to wrap it around the hoop here at whatever length I want. And I just wrapped it twice and then again cut my tail. So you can make these as long as you want, totally up to you. All right, I'm having some technical issues here with this one, but it's working. All right, so I'm going to have that one dangling down kind of long. Hopefully you can see the glass glitter in there. It's really pretty. Okay, now we're going to add some of our feathers. So I'm going to take that same wired thread. And you don't have to glue this stuff because it is wired. It's pretty awesome. So I'm wrapping it all the way up my stem until I like the way it looks. I just think it adds a little bit more detail. It makes it look pretty cool. And then get this out of the way. This came undone, so I'm just going to have to move it for the time being. I'm just going to do the same thing, wrapping it around the base twice and then cutting my tail off. I was playing around with spelling things out with this wire thread, but I definitely need the thicker kind that Prima makes. But I love any kind of wired thread. It's just awesome for making things flex to a certain position, make it look more natural with feathers. Love this stuff. Just wrapping it around, and you don't need glue with it. That's the best part. Jazz hands? Is that seriously one, Carrie? Tell me that is not an emoticon. That would be hilarious. Jazz hands. That is so funny. How does someone find out these? Is there a website that tells you what they have? Because that's really funny. All right, same thing with this one, just wrapping it around twice. And just do different lengths and play with it until you're happy. You can add as many feathers as you want, as little, totally up to you. Okay, so for the last step on this one, all that I did was add a few random pieces of junkyard findings that I had in my stash. I used a gear, I used one of the clock hands from Ingold Balm for the gear. I put it inside of my bottle cap here, which I will attempt to do, whether it stays because it's still wet, who knows. So it was like the perfect size to just fit right down in there, and it is going to stay, what do you know. So I just added that gear in there just for some added detail. Okay, and then I added this little bad boy with some more of the wired thread just dangling down. I could go crazy with details, but I usually tone it down because, goodness, you're a censored queen, Carrie. What are you doing on there? Everybody's trying the jazz hands, but it's not working. Okay, so just did the same thing with that one. And just gonna wrap it around. And that is pretty much it. Let me look at the original. I'm missing one step, and that's it, y'all. So at the top of my feathers, just for a little more added detail, I took the jeans buttons, and this is some more Ingold Balm Junkyard Findings. Comes in this pack right here. They are so fun to play with. Item number 891640. And I just took some of my jean buttons and put them at the very base of my feather, like right where the stem meets the soft feather part, just for a little bit of added detail. I could literally add and add and add. I have to make myself stop, and I still go over all my shows, so it's crazy. It's really hard for me to do anything simple. One day, y'all, I promise. Okay, that is it, y'all. Let me show you up close what this one looks like. Granted, we do have a purple flower now, and I am missing a string on the bottom. It came off. That's the joy of live TV, but I'll add that on in just a minute. So I've got all of that dangling down on the bottom. I'll grab the original to show you how it's supposed to look when you're not rushed for time. I'll go ahead and show you all the other ones. And that is it for tonight, everybody. I hope that you learned something. I hope everybody feels like they can achieve these, because you really can, I promise. It's really not that hard. It's just all repetitive work, doing the same thing over and over and over. If anybody has any questions, let me know, and I would love to answer them for you really quickly. Other than that, we are a wrap. Let me get the original in here. I seem to be showing all the originals. When you have time and you're not live, you can add more details and, you know, things always go wrong on live TV. Oh, on this one, I took a Sharpie, like a paint pen. I think I have it over here really quick. Hold on. Just a Sharpie paint pen, and literally just started drawing on the feather and just started doing, like, let's see here. I'll show you this one. I just started kind of coloring some pieces, doing polka dots. It's really fun to play with these feathers that come in your chipboard, y'all. Dip them in stuff, have fun with your art ingredients. I mean, these things are really versatile, and don't be intimidated by the size, because you can cut them down. So everything can be made to be used. So if you have any questions, let me know. I don't see any. I'm glad you like the purple flower one. I'd say this one's my favorite, just because it has my favorite spray on it of all time, but they're all, I try to do something for everyone, like steampunk. I felt like this one was a little more trendy. I just tied some laces and beads on the end of it, just dangling down. But I hope you guys enjoyed the show. Stay tuned Tuesday for Delana's little altered book album, which is amazing. Check out the blog to see pictures of it. Anybody has any questions? I don't see any, so I think we are good. Yes, I did use a lot of gold. I'm usually a silver person, but this glass glitter is amazing. And the micro beads, I'm so hooked on this stuff, y'all. Look how little I have left. And I got this maybe, I don't know, 2 weeks, 3 weeks ago. I love it. I would not be Miranda if it was simple. It's very true. Thank you so much for coming out. I'm going to hit stop record now. And then I will stop the broadcast in 1 second so everybody can say goodnight to each other. Thank you, Carrie and Delana, for modding for me and being here. I know I missed a lot of the chat, so I'm sorry if I didn't answer anything. I'm sure they got to it really quickly. So thank you, everybody, for coming. Hope you like them. Give them a try. If you make one, tag me in it on Facebook. I would absolutely love to see it. I would love to see if you guys made these. Thanks for everything, y'all. Have a good day. Bye, everybody.